morning students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good and well. Watch this videos and be benefited. Last week we learned geography about atmosphere. About atmosphere we saw the layers of atmosphere, structure of the atmosphere, then greenhouse, about greenhouse, global warming, then ozone depletion, so many things we learnt about the atmosphere. I think you would have understood the lesson. Be benefited by watching this videos, children. This week we are going to learn in social science civics, that is unit 12, our constitution. That is in civics it is lesson 1, but according to this history civics it is unit 12. Don't worry about the unit. This is first lesson of this civics. I want to briefly tell about the nutshell of this lesson. First we'll have the introduction of our constitution, then role of our constitution assembly, and then we are going to learn about the framing of our constitution. Then in framing of the constitution we'll be learning about the role of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, and then adoption of our constitution. In adoption of our constitution we'll be learning more about Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, and then below this we are going to learn about the preamble. Then next to that, sources of the constitution, nature of the state, and then objectives of the constitution, then features of the constitution. Under future of constitution we are going to see federal system, parliamentary system, organs of the government, independent judiciary, fundamental rights, then directive principles of state policy, single citizenship, and universal adult franchise. Okay children, let's go inside the lesson. The constitution of a country is the fundamental law of that country. All laws must be made according to the principles laid down in the constitution. The constitution lists the rights and duties of the citizens, the powers of the government, and so on. Our country gained independence from the British rule on 15 August 1947. After independence there was an urgent need to lay down rules and regulations to guide the governance of our country. The Constitution of India compresses these rules and regulations. Our Constitution was prepared after a great deal of discussion. The group of representatives who prepared it formed the Constituent Assembly. This is the introduction of this lesson, children. Next we'll see the role of the Constituent Assembly. The Constituent Assembly was elected in 1946 for the specific purpose of the framing of constitution. It comprised members belonging to different political parties, communities, and regions of India. Among them were Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, then Dr. Rajendra Prasad, then Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Sri Bishwanath Das, Sardar Baldev Singh, then Sri Frank Antony, and then we have two women. Renuka Roy. Then includes the Sarojini Naidu, two women. Then we are going to see about the framing of our constitution, how this constitution was framed. The Constituent Assembly appointed a drafting committee of 6 members under the chairmanship of Dr. Bhimrao Ramji Ambedkar. They prepared a draft of our constitution. The views and options of the citizens of India were taken into consideration. Suitable features from the constructions of other countries such as UK, the USA and Ireland were also incorporated. Now we will see some of the role of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Who is he and some of the role what he did? Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, popularly known as Baba Sahab, is called the father of the Indian Constitution. He is the main cause for this Indian Constitution. He was a popular lawyer and a social reformer. As chairman of the drafting committee, Dr. Ambedkar defined the vision and goal of our constitution. He ensured the inclusion of fundamental rights, which specifically abolished untouchability, guaranteed equal rights to all citizens, and prohibited discrimination of all kinds. This is all about the Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Next we will see what is the adoption of our constitution. On 26th November 1949, the Indian Constitution was formally passed by the Constituent Assembly. On 26th January 1950, the Constitution came into force and India was declared a sovereign democratic republic. Later, the words socialist and secular were added to it. We celebrate 26th January as our Republic Day every year. Once the Indian Constitution was adopted, Dr. Rajendra Prasad was elected as the first president of independent India. Next we'll see about the preamble. What is preamble? Here you see some of the picture of the preamble. We'll see what is a preamble. The preamble is a short introduction to the constitution. The idea of the preamble was borrowed from the Constitution of the United States of America. The preamble helps us to understanding our constitution by appointing our source of the constitution, explaining the nature of the state that the country will be governed by, stating the objectives which the constitution aims to provide and implement. The preamble is not justiciable. It cannot be enforced in a court of law. It can be used only to interpret certain aspects of the constitution. This is all about the preamble of our constitution. Next we'll see what is the source of the constitution. The preamble states, "We, the people of India, adopt, enact and give to ourselves this constitution." This means that the ultimate authority lies with the people of India. People govern themselves through their representatives. This is the source of the constitution. Next we'll see the nature of the state. What is that? Sovereign. This means that India is an independent country and is not under the control of any external or internal power. No other country can be interfere in India's internal matters. Next, we'll see the socialist. What is that? This word was added to the preamble in 1976 by the 42nd Amendment Act. Its main purpose is to end inequality of income and status. It also aims to provide to decent standard of living to all. The Indian Constitution therefore aimed at providing equal opportunities to all. Next, secular. India is a secular country. The word secular was also added to the preamble by the 42nd Amendment Act. Secularism means that the state protects all religions equally. There is no discrimination based on one's religion. Individuals have the freedom to profess, practice, and spread their respective religions. Next, we see about the democratics. What is democratic or democracy? A government chosen by the people is called a democracy or democratic. Every 5 years, general elections are held in which people vote to elect their government. After this democratic, we will see about the republic. What is republic? A government chosen by the people is called a democracy. Every 5 years, general elections are held in which people vote to elect their government. That is about the democratic. What is republic? What is republic? Republic is an India became a republic in 1950. A republic is a form of government in which the offices of the country cannot be inherited. Every Indian citizen has the right to be elected to any office in the country. Okay, children. Okay, this is the lesson about our constitution. We saw some introduction. Below that, role of the Constitution Assembly, we have Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, then we have Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, and then Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, and Dr. Rajendra Prasad, and Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, then Sri Vishwanath Das, then Sardar Baldev Singh, then Sri Frank Antony, and then we have two women named Renuka Roy and then Sarojini Naidu. Below this, we learnt about the framing of our constitution. Below that, we learnt role of Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Below that, we learnt the adoption of our constitution, and then about the preamble, then source of the constitution, then nature of the state. Okay, children, below that we learned this socialism, secular, and then democracy, and then republic. Okay, children, today we'll stop till this republic. And upcoming classes, we will be learning about the objectives of the constitution. Okay, below objectives of the constitution, we will be learning the justice. what is justice? There are three kinds of justice, that is social, economic and political. In detail we will learn about the objectives of the constitution. Okay children, I appreciate all the students who wrote the test well. More than 50 children have written the test. I very happy. And those who did not attend the test, I want you to do the test next class. See the link and you have to do the test. Then also the assignment, two assignment I gave you. Some of you did very creatively. Really I appreciate the students. Even though we are doing this assignment in online, I really appreciate and salute the students who did the project. Okay children, we'll see you in the next class about the remaining part of this, our constitution. Thank you children.